EA Sports. It's in the game.
EA Sports, it's in the game, baby.
Madden NFL 2003.
Welcome to Madden 2003 on the Xbox. We're coming down and everything. We're coming down the road and everything where we only have, let's see, it's 2003 and we're going to 2017. So we got quite a bit to go. But what I wanted to briefly talk about is the amount of games on the Xbox. This series of the games are actually better on the Xbox. So the graphics are better, everything's smoother. So that's the reason we went with it. So just wanted to give you an FYI of why we're going the way we're going. So let's
watch. This guy has all the tools you look for. Great arm, pocket presence, and the ability to hit a receiver anywhere on the field. There's not too many like this guy, and we could see him put up big numbers in this one.
The Seahawks defense is counting on some big plays from its secondary as they attempt to short circuit this potent passing offense. And it'll be up to the defensive line to get some pressure on the quarterback and force him to throw a few ill-advised passes that'll end up in the defense's hands.
This is what you hate to see as a visitor coming in here, a team that's focused and really ready to play.
And let's go to the field for the coin toss.
You have called heads, is that correct? The Eagles call heads and have won the toss. They choose to receive.
Number 9, looks like he's just about ready to kick this one off. He gets the kick away. Mitchell will try to bring this one back. The Eagles will start the drive from the 32. First and 10. With an extra DB, the defense is in the nickel. Dropping back, rolling out to his right. And he's knocked out of bounds at the 44. So they have first and 10 here. And he's tackled at the 45. He couldn't find much running room there.
The defense is trying to shut down the running game early to force him to pack. We'll have to see if it works and causes him to give up on it here in the first half.
And they need about 9. Ball on their own 45. With an extra DB, the defense is in the nickel. Penalty marker down.
Prior to the snap, false start, number 69. Offense.
They're moving in the wrong direction.
A play like that will just kill a coach. You're trying to put a drive together, and then boom, something like that happens.
Great.
directing the pass. Short throw. Great catch.
Springs
makes the tackle at the 47-yard line. He pulled the trigger quickly.
As hard as he throws it, he always seems to put the ball right on the receiver's number.
They need seven. Quick drop. Goes to the middle. The defender broke that play up.
Brown didn't even give the receiver a chance.
One thing remains constant. No matter what kind of quarterback you are, rushing your throws is going to end up in incompletion or worse.
Ingram will be looking to give his team good field position here. He took his eyes off it. It's a live ball. The Eagles grab the live ball. It's first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Changing the play now. Drops back. Looking for a receiver. Looking for a receiver in the middle. It was Tech.
Tongue.
Knock that one down.
Yep, nothing fancy there. Don't even give the receiver a chance. Just knock it down.
It's second down and 10 to go. McNair with three wide receivers. Tosses it right. Number 87 was the intended target. He couldn't get it to his man.
No, and maybe he got held up in the line because their timing was really off on that pass.
Third and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. McMahon sets up, looking to throw, passing right.
Thrash
was the intended target on that pass attempt. They tried throwing for the first, but the pass was dropped.
You can bet that the next third down pass won't be going to that guy.
So they're almost within their kicker's range. Set. Landetta lines up in the backfield for the punt. Ingram lines up deep for the punt return. So they have first and 10 here.
Somebody get over there! Get over there! Throw that up! Throw that up! Set!
The Seahawks using motion. Looking downfield. Looking for an option. Dilfer throws this one away. He had defenders applying intense pressure on that play.
And that's a right decision in that case. Get rid of the ball and take the incomplete.
Second and 10. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. He takes the delayed handoff, and he's stopped at the 17. Alexander was dropped behind the line.
Yeah, and if you want to talk about the most effective way to stop the run, it's playing on the other side of the ball. When you get penetration like that, it's very hard for the offense to get positive yardage.
And they need about 9. Ball on their own 17. Looking downfield. Passes it out to the left, and he makes the grab. So we have first and 10 here. Four linebackers this time. Back to pass. Looking for an option.
Dilfer
lets it fly. He hits his receiver. He put everything he had behind that throw.
That's one way to make sure your receiver doesn't drop the ball. You throw it so hard that he has to catch it in self-defense. You just put it right on him.
First and 10. Ball on their own 41. Barber brings him down at the 45-yard line. Pickup of about 5. They need 5. Only one man in the backfield. Dilfer gives the ball off. And he stopped at the 49. 4-yard gain on the play. Third and one coming up on this play. The defender, Taylor, with the stop at the 38-yard line. Effective running there, and they pick up a first down.
A few more runs like that, and this defense is going to get an earful from the coach.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Roger, Roger, watch your man.
Dilfer gets set. They'll go with a pass. Surveying the field. Throws over to his right. The defense hurried that throw.
He had no choice but to get rid of the ball.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. The Seahawks using motion. Dropping back. Pump faking with the pass. Evans couldn't make the catch. He really felt pressure there.
Yeah, he felt those guys closing in and gunning the ball out of there.
So they dug themselves into a hole here, a long third down situation. Looking to pass, steps up into the pocket. Dilfer passes left. Robinson can't come up with a catch, and it brings up fourth down.
Sometimes you see players try to run before they catch it. Knowing that he had to get the first there, he probably was thinking about where he was going before he caught the ball. Maybe that's why he dropped it.
Fiegels is looking for a good punt here. Mitchell looks like he's ready for the return. The defense will try to force them to punt again as they did the last time the offense had the ball. First and 10. McNair passes to his left, and the defender brings him down at the 29. Perfect spiral on that pass.
With an arm like that, there isn't a pass that he can't make.
At the end of the first quarter, it's knotted up. Seattle, 0. Philadelphia, 0.
Field when they keep making mistakes like that.
Second and 6. The Eagles line up with 3 wide receivers. Surveying the field. Rolling out to his right. Mitchell, the intended receiver. King did a nice job knocking that ball down.
Nothing will frustrate a receiver more than knocking away his pass.
Third and 6. Looking to throw. Throwing. He hits his receiver. And he's tackled at the 34. First and 10. Ball on their own 34.
Set.
McNair sets up.
Cut.
He gets the toss. And he's stopped at the 33. Staley was dropped before he could get back to the line.
Yeah, you can't run without good blocking.
Tosses it right. That one goes off the receiver's hands and it brings up fourth down.
Yeah, if you drop those third down passes, you're going to have a lonely flight home.
So they need about three here.
Set.
Landetta is back to punt.
Cut.
A high, long, deep kick. Just about ready to get this drive started after being forced to punt on their last possession. It's first and 10.
Set.
Mealy, the man in motion. Drops back. He's looking. Dilfer with the pass. Batted down.
Vincent.
Batted that pass down.
If you don't take your time and you start to rush your throw, that's what you're going to see happen.
And it looks like an offset on. He's going to throw. Faking. Dilfer lets it fly. A hard throw, but no catch. The pass falls incomplete.
Well, he slung it in there, but the receiver just couldn't come up with it.
Deep in their own territory. Lines up in the backfield for the punt. The punt returner gets under this one. The offense takes over after they were unable to get any points on their last drive. So they have first and 10 here. Off. He tried to find a hole and just got what he could.
Yeah, he tried to stretch it outside, but the defense was quick to react to the play and even quicker to move off their blocks and get in a position to cover the hole.
Second and 8. Throws over to his right. Lewis can't come up with it on that attempt. A lot of heat on that pass.
You know, some of these passes are timing patterns. If the receiver gets bumped at the line or gets thrown out of whack at all, then that's going to happen.
Third and 8. Ned, passing to the right. He got his hand in there to knock it down.
You know, the quarterback needs to put that ball in a position where the defender can't get to it. That didn't happen there.
So they're almost within their kicker's range. Ball on the 41-yard line. He'll try to pin them close to the goal line. And it's a long punt, and he chooses not to return this one. So the offense takes over. The last time they had the ball, they had a very tough time getting anything going. So they'll try to get a little breathing room here. Coming back. Throws it. Strong. The intended receiver. Lots of pressure, but he was able to get rid of it.
He really had to rush that throw. That was a situation where the defensive line made the job easy for the defensive backs.
Second and 10. Ball on their own four. The Seahawks line up with two backs behind the quarterback, using motion. Flag down.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense.
And now they'll move backward.
Now the offense needs to try even harder to pick up the first down.
In their own territory. Dilfer gets set. They'll go with a pass. Pass is left. And he hits his target. First and 10 here. Ball on their own 19.
Set, weak, weak. Watch the back.
And we've reached the 2-minute mark here in the first half. So they have first and 10 here. Caught. 5-yard gain. Second and 4. Ball on their own 25. No completion there. He just couldn't find a way to control.
It's frustrating as a coach when you see a guy make a great one-handed catch and then drop the easy one.
Third down and 4 coming up on this one.
Outside, outside.
Set. Only one man back. He's looking to pass. With the throw,
Mealy,
the intended receiver. The defender is able to put the pressure on, forcing the incomplete pass.
Getting pressure on the quarterback is the easiest way to disrupt a pass play. The defensive line should take full credit for that play.
So the punt team gets ready as we near halftime.
Mitchell
is back to receive this kick.
Mitchell
waves for the fair catch. The offense couldn't get anything going on their last drive, going 3 and out. Until they can get closer, we'll probably just see throws from them here on out.
Set,
looking to throw. tosses it right. He juggled it a bit and then lost it. He had plenty of juice on that one.
Well, he slung it in there, but the receiver just couldn't come up with it.
I think they'll keep throwing it to try to get into field goal range.
Second and 10.
Ball on their own 36.
McNair
under center, looking to throw. Passes it. Nice connection. And it looks like this one will be spotted at the 45.
It's third down, two to go.
Directing traffic.
Set.
Dropping back. He's looking, rolling out to his right. Throwing. It's broken up.
Kirkland knocked it down.
An interception would have been nice, but a great play either way.
Landetta will come into this game to punt. He kicks a line drive. Ingram looks this punt into his hands. The defense will try to force them to punt again as they did the last time the offense had the ball. Getting closer to halftime in this tight battle, and they're looking to move downfield to set up a field goal attempt. So they have first and 10 here. Looking to pass. Throws it. Great catch. Bishop makes the play at the 42-yard line. He got in there for his first tackle.
No need to rush the throw or force one where there's double coverage. And they got to remember there's nothing wrong with going into halftime all tied up.
Passing right. Nice completion. The 10. Touchdown, Seattle. The defender was caught out of position on the score.
Yeah, the defenders were looking one way while the play was going the other.
Extra point is good. And with that score, they're up by a touchdown. Number 9. Looks like he's just about ready to kick this one off. He sends it off. He'll start upfield. Philadelphia, he's down by one touchdown. It's first and 10. Four linemen and three linebackers lined up to catch it. Looking downfield, McNair sends the pass away. No gain.
They need a big play here if they want to have any shot at scoring before the half.
About 9. The Eagles line up with four wide receivers. He surveys the field, rolls right with the throw. Nice connection. And the defender brings him down at the 17. That's the end of the second quarter with the score Seattle 7, Philadelphia 0. So let's pick up the action. So before we start the third quarter, here's a quick look at how both teams have fared in the first half. Akers is just about ready to kick this one away. He sends this one toward the end zone. Williams will return this one. The Seahawks will start this drive from the 25-yard line. Melissa, anything new from the sideline?
Thanks, Al. The Seahawks coach is pleased that his team has been able to throw the ball pretty well, and it's helped them to their lead. Running the ball now will be their main focus, though. Don't be surprised, however, to see them throw on first down a few times, Al.
Thanks for that report, Melissa. Dilfer passing over to his left. Taylor makes a great play by breaking that pass up.
Great position and great reaction made that play happen.
So it's second and 10. Dilfer passing over to his left, right to the defender. First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. McNair gets set, drops back, looking for an option, throws it, nice connection. Williams makes the tackle at the 24, and with that catch, he has his first of the day. It's first and 10. Brought down at the 19.
Even if your running game isn't over effective, running consistently with your big guys will tire out the defense because they're always taking hits and getting banged up.
Let's see what they can do in the red zone. Staley to carry it. Brown stops him for negative yardage. He got in there for his first tackle. Faced with a long third down play here. Set. With two extra defensive backs, defense is in the dime. He's going to throw. He surveys the field. Number 87 was the intended target, so the pass falls incomplete in the end zone. Akers will come in looking to try the field goal. The kick is up. With two tight ends available. They'll go with a pass. Throws over to his right. Nice reception. That pass was right on the money. The receiver was there to make the catch with his first reception. About a yard to go. The Eagles are in the offset I formation. Gets rid of it. Nice reception. The 40, the 30, the 20. The 10. Touchdown, Seattle. He caught the pass for the touchdown.
Anything that goes that far, that fast, ought to have dinner and an in-flight movie.
And it's on its way. The extra point attempt is good. And so they turn that drive into a great one as it ends with a touchdown.
The more touchdown drives, the better. Now they'll go back to the sidelines and see why they were able to beat the defense for six. And they'll try and repeat those results the next time they get the ball.
He kicks it off. Mitchell will bring this one upfield. Well, there's an injury on the play, and we'll go to the sideline as soon as we get the information.
First and 10. Dropping back, looking for an option. Tosses it right. Thrash was the intended receiver. Lots of pressure on the quarterback.
Yeah, he had to get rid of the ball in a hurry.
It's second down and 10 to go.
Somebody get over there. Set, hurt.
He's looking to pass. He surveys the field. Rolling right with the pass. Number 87 couldn't make the catch. Simmons broke that pass up.
You know, he did what you taught to do. That's take away the ability for the receiver to catch the ball. He can't catch it when you knock it down.
Right. Well, listen, what can you tell us about his injury?
Well, Al, it doesn't look good. I spoke to the team doctor, and he indicated that it's the type of injury that will take some time to heal. They're hopeful that he won't be out long, but his return is doubtful.
Thanks, Melissa. Well, that's good news because on the replay, it looked a lot more serious than that. They'll probably miss the rest of the game. So they have first and 10 here. Ball at midfield. Calling an audible. They'll go with a pass. Looking for an option. Rolls right. Passing right. It's broken up. The defender was able to get in there to disrupt the pass.
Getting pressure on the quarterback is the easiest way to disrupt a pass play. The defensive line should take full credit for that play.
So it's second and 10. McMahon under center. They'll go with a pass. Passing right. It's battled up. Well, he fired that one in there, but it fell incomplete.
He never looked comfortable in the pocket on that pass.
So they dug themselves into a hole here, a long third down situation. Nickelback in this time. They'll go with a pass. Looking downfield. Throws over to his right. It was tipped. He threw the ball into pretty heavy coverage.
The defense was all over that one. They're lucky that one wasn't intercepted.
Landetta is looking for a good punt here. Not much hang time on this one. The offense with a lot of success through the air on the last drive as they move downfield for the touchdown. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 33. Dilfer with the throw. Taylor takes him down at the 48-yard line. Ingram at his feet, just barely in bounds, but makes the catch.
That's something that takes excellent body control and years of practice to perfect. And you can make sideline catches like that. A receiver is even more valuable because nearly every pass is a possible completion.
The ball is right at midfield. Bishop makes the tackle at the 47. He couldn't reach the corner on that run.
Yeah, as a back, you need to take what the defense is going to give you. That time, they wouldn't give him an inch.
Second down, and they need 15 for the first.
It's all on us. Come on, you.
Dilfer gets set. They'll go with a pass. And it's caught. Bishop brought him down for his third tackle. He had a quick release on that pass.
And when you talk about precision passing, that's what you mean.
Third and 6.
Somebody get over there. Get over there. Switch.
With an extra DB, the defense is in the nickel. throws it out over to the left. And he dropped it.
Robinson couldn't hang on.
I think he just took his eyes off that one.
Fiegels is just about ready to punt this one away.
Mitchell
sets up, waiting for the punt. We'll look for some good blocking on this return. And they're about ready to get this drive started after the last series ended with a punt. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 18.
McNair
using split back, looking for room. And it looks like this one will be spotted at the 19-yard line. This one stays on the ground.
As a coach, you need to make sure that you establish your running game as a weapon that can hurt the other team.
So we've reached the end of the third quarter with the Seattle Seahawks ahead of the Philadelphia Eagles, 14-0. And we'll start the fourth quarter. Eight to go. Ball on their own 19. Four linemen and three linebackers lined up defensively. Throws it. It's broken up. He took a big chance on that pass.
Yeah, that guy trusts his arm. He thought he could rifle it in there.
They'll be faced with a long third down play here. He's going to throw. Looking downfield. Rolling out to his right. It's a throw. So a big hit on the quarterback forces the incompletion.
He really had to rush that throw. That was a situation where the defensive line made the job easy for the defensive back.
Is back to receive this kick. Ingram signals fair catch on this punt. So the offense takes over, still trying to figure out this defense. So they have first and 10 here. Was in on the play again for another tick on the stat sheet.
A good mix of run plays and pass plays is important. It helps you keep the other team honest out there.
Eight to go. Nickelback in this time. Dropping back. Gets the pass off. No completion there.
Robinson drops it.
And nothing is more disheartening to a quarterback than a drop pass.
Melissa, anything new from the sideline?
Well, Al, it doesn't look good. I spoke to the team doctor, and he indicated that it's the type of injury that will take some time to heal. They're hopeful that he won't be out long, but his return is doubtful.
Melissa, thanks for the update, and obviously we're very happy that it's not that serious. He's trying to pin them down inside their own 10 on this one. And he signals for the fair catch. So the offense takes over. The last time they had the ball, they had a very tough time getting anything going. First and 10. Ball on their own 20.
McMahon
sets up, looking to pass, throws over to his right, and he can't hang on it. He should have caught that one.
There's just no excuse for that. He's getting paid a lot of money to make those catches.
So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 20. Four linemen and three linebackers lined up defensively. And it's complete. 8-yard gain.
third and maybe two.
The Eagles line up with two backs behind the quarterback. Passing right, hits the target with the pass. And that's a gain of about eight. First and 10. Ball on their own 36. Directing traffic. Dropping back. He surveys the field. Throws it. Thrash was the intended target.
McNair didn't show much touch on that pass.
Even if you have a cannon arm, you'll never be a successful quarterback if you can't get the ball to your receiver.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 36. They'll go with a pass. Throws it. And he hits his target. He displayed a lightning release on that pass.
Not only does he have a powerful arm, but he also has a quick release and accuracy to go along with it.
Ball right around midfield. It looks like three wideouts this time. Changing the play now. Directing traffic. They'll go with a pass. Tosses it right. He got his hands on it, but the pass was incomplete.
I'm not sure why he dropped that one. The quarterback delivered it right to him.
The ball is right at midfield. With an extra DB, the defense is in the nickel. Tongue takes him down at the 44. So that tackle was his third. About six to go.
Set,
McNair sees something in the defense. Calling an audible. Looking downfield. Looking for a receiver with the pass. Hits his man with the pass. He does a nice job bringing in the pass.
This guy's just like a gunslinger. He's never in a position where he thinks that a throw is impossible.
So they have first and 10 here. Eighth play of this drive. He hands it off. Staley with the nice move. And he stopped at the 4-yard line. They're inside the 5. Almost at the 2-minute mark now. Looking for a receiver. Tosses it over the middle. He threw a great pass, and they get into the end zone.
The quarterback knew that he had to make that pass perfect, and he got the job done on that one.
Extra point is good. Akers will be kicking off. He gets the kick away. He's trying to give his team good field position. Their last drive ended with a 3-and-out as the offense comes out onto the field again. So they have first and 10 here. Ball on their own 21. Alexander, the deep down. He'll use the spin. Bishop with the stop. The 21. So that tackle now gives him 4.
They've almost got this game won, but they still need to run it to make the defense use their timeout.
So it's 2nd and 10. The defense is behind the screen. Dilfer gives the ball off. Taylor brought him down for his 3rd tackle.
I'm guessing this should be a run. The defense can't be lollygagging around. Because if they are and they give up a first, this one's over.
Third and 10 coming up.
Ball on their own 21. Looking for a seam. He's out to the 30.
The 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Seattle.
That was so close to the ball coming back to me. So close.
Up. The point anchor is good. Number 9 will be kicking off. He sends it off. Mitchell is heading upfield. There's a flag on the play.
Holding, receiving team. Loss of 10 yards. And now called by Seattle. Two timeouts remaining.
So we have first and 10 here. Ball on their own 25. Looking to pass. He's looking.
McNair.
Throw. Loses one tackle.
Lucas.
Stopping for his third tackle so far. First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Four-man front this time. They'll go with a pass. Intercepted. Breaks free of the defender. He's at the 40.
The 30. The 20. The 10.
Touchdown, Seahawks. The defender was all over that one.
That was a great pick. He was reading the quarterback like a book.
On its way, the point anchor is good. Number 9 is just about ready to kick this one away. He sends this one toward the end zone.
Mitchell
fields it cleanly. He shakes a defender. The Eagles will start the drive from the 28-yard line.
Any run plays in the playbook should be thrown out because they need points fast, and the only way they're going to get them is by throwing the ball.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 28.
Set,
looking to throw. Gets the pass off. The defender broke that play up. Bell didn't even let it get to the receiver.
He was in a great position to make that play.
They have to move him down quickly here on second down. Second and 10. Looking for room. And he stopped at the 34. They try the ground attack again.
They must have seen something in the defense that told them that they could run the ball there.
I'm just calling this game a loss. Anyways, this is David B69. Thought I actually had this game and everything, and I was going to be able to catch up, but I just didn't have my lucks today. So, till next time, this is David B69 on our way to Madden 17. It's coming this week, folks. Till then.
This game is over. The final score is Seattle 28, Philadelphia 7.